Dear colleagues, today I would like to present my report, Development of Advanced Multilayered Composite Scintillators Based on Epitaxial Structure of Garnet Compound. This my presentation is a result of collaboration of my group from Institute of Physics Kazimierz Wielki University in Bydgoszcz in Poland, together with Professor Nikol Group from Institute of Physics Academy of Science Czech Republic, and Professor Sidlecki Group from Institute of Scintillators Material, National Academy of Science of Ukraine in Kharkiv, as well as Professor Yoshikawa Group from the Institute of Material Research, Tohoku University in Japan. The outline of my presentation contains principle of composite scintillator working and two approaches for their development. I would like to consider the creation composite scintillator screen based on cerium-doped mixed garnet film and GGG substrate with a different content. NECA approach in development of composite scintillator connected with the creation of such type scintillators using LUAC garnet in film and crystal form with a different dope. I would like also talk about composite scintillator screens and consider for this purposes epitaxial structure based on the mixed garnet compound. Finally, conclusion of my presentation. The principle of composite scintillator working connected with the different pathway for particles in quanta in composite scintillators based on epitaxial structure of garnet and other oxide compound. This means that alpha particles and beta particles stop it mainly in film scintillators, but gamma quanta stop it mainly in large substrate. Simultaneous registration of alpha, beta, and gamma quanta occur by the way the separation of decay kinetic coming from the film and crystal part of composite scintillator. Crucial point here is the respective time value for registration, for instance, alpha particle and gamma quanta. So it will be nice if the respective ratio, for instance, T alpha, T gamma, T alpha, T beta, and T beta, T gamma ratio will be large as possible for chosen type of composite. So usually such ratio must be above 1.5 for time discrimination of signal from the different part of composite scintillator. For creation of composite scintillators, we apply the liquid phase epitaxy method. This is very nice method for producing film scintillator single crystalline film form with a thickness from 1 to 100 range. We use for producing film the substrate scintillators and deep such substrate scintillator in the mel based mainly on lead oxide flux and crystal forming components. I must say that creation of composite scintillators is this nice occasion to join together all achievement in development of film scintillators together with the main type of advanced scintillators in bulk crystal form. First of all, I talk about garnet compound. We look on GRGG garnets. Now it's very famous scintillators with very large light yield. So we would like to receive for producing composite scintillator the substrate from this garden. For this reason, we collaborate with Professor Yoshikawa group from Tohoku University, who can produce the substrate with a different gallium content. We also work together with Professor Sidlecki group from the Institute of Scintillators Materials in Ukraine, and such group produce the crystals of LUAC doped with praseodymium or doped with scandium ions and can produce the substrate from this type of crystals. I would like firstly consider the composite scintillators based on the mixed garnet film containing gadolinium, lutetium, terbium, aluminium garnet containers and GGG substrate with a different content between the 2.5 and 3.0, producing in ISMA in Ukraine and CNA in Japan. Based on this type of substrate, we developed several types of composite scintillators, including three combinations. First of all, gadolinium, lutetium, aluminium, gallium based film doped with cerium on GG substrate with gallium content 2.5. Gadolinium, aluminium, gallium garnet film on the GGG substrate with gallium content 2.5, but the content of gallium ions in film is less due to fact that we need separated the decay kinetic of different type of garnet in such mixed, such composite scintillator. We also consider the combination of terbium aluminium garnet film on GGG substrate with the gallium content 2.5 and 2.7. Based on developed two-layered composite scintillators, we also create several type of three-layered composite scintillator. First type of three-layered composite scintillator is combination of TAC, doped with cerium film with mixed lutetium, gadolinium, aluminium garnet based films on GGG substrate with gallium content 2.5. We also consider another type of combination for creation three-layered composite scintillators based mainly on YAC cerium single crystalline film, TAC single crystalline film as second layers, and GGG substrate with gallium content 2.5 and 2.7. The columinescent spectra of film a crystal part composite scintillators contain main cerium emission band in the visible range with a peak position between blue range up to yellow, depending on the content of films and crystal film strength in the dodecahedral position of garnet holes where cerium ions are localized. The luminescence scintillator properties of film and crystal for producing composite scintillators are concentrated in this table. I must say that for producing composite scintillator, of course, we need the substrate. Here you can see the scintillator's properties of different kind of substrate with different gallium content, different decay kinetic and quite different light yield. And also the film component of composite scintillators, including simple garnet, YAC doped with cerium, LUAC doped with cerium, and TBAG doped with cerium, as well as some kind of mixed garnet based on gadolinium, lutetium, aluminium garnet, gallium cations, and some examples of mixed garnet here where we have quite close content to content of substrate. I must say that for composite scintillators, most important, of course, decay time of registration of scintillators, scintillation from different kind of ionization radiation. In such way, we can separate the signal from such type part of composite scintillator. Also important light yield. I must say that for producing composite scintillator, we can use several type of film with quite high light yield, comparable with the light even in substrate in case of LUAC, in case of TAC films, but also can apply film with quite small light yield, for instance, for this one. But it's maybe not so important for creation of composite scintillators, because we need, first of all, the differences in decay kinetic. So we can join such type film with the chosen type of substrate in such a way receive good separation between scintillator signal. So I would like to present some result related to possible type of two-layered composite scintillators and consider the scintillator properties of such type composite scintillator. First of all, when we started with creation composite scintillators using liquid phase epitaxial method, necessary to consider the misfit between the lattice constants of film and lattice constants of substrate, because the condition of film single crystal film growth is that the such misfit can be below 1.5. When the film possesses the lattice constants above such value, a process of such field cannot be performed on the chosen type of substrate. So we can receive the composite scintillators based on gadolinium, lutetium, gallium, aluminium films grown on GGG substrate with gallium content 2.5. We also create another type of composite scintillators based on TAC doped with cerium films and GGG substrate with a gallium content 2.5 and 2.7. Next examples of two-layered composite scintillators is the film based on gadolinium, gallium, aluminium cations in film with quite smaller content than content of substrate, where the gallium concentration is equal to 3. It's a very famous bulk crystal scintillator. But I may say that application of TAC film for producing such type scintillators on GGG substrate with gallium content 3 is impossible due to larger misfit than the border condition for producing single crystalline film. So it's quite larger than value 1.5. So, firstly, when we started with creation of composite scintillators, necessary to consider the properties of substrate, the bulk part of composite scintillators, and consider the possibility of simultaneous registration of different type of ionization radiation using even substrate. So we investigate such possibility using two type of substrate with gallium content 2.5 and gallium content equal to 3. So as you can see from this figure, the separation of diffa curves under alpha particle registration and gamma quanta registration is significantly larger in case GRGG crystal with gallium content 3. If you look on respective decay time ratio, decay time under alpha particle registration and gamma quanta registration. For GGG crystal with gallium content equal to 3, such value is something between 1.45 up to 1.5. It's enough for separation signal coming from such type of radiation. But we hope that in case of creation composite scintillation containing crystal substrate and film, the separation of decay profile in case of registration, different kind of radiation will be higher. Anyway, we also tested the substrate using three type of radiation, including alpha particle, beta particle, and gamma quanta in Professor Yoshikawa laboratory in University Tohoku in Japan, and for crystal with the gallium content receive quite good separation of signal in case three type of radiation. So we can separate it even beta particle, gamma quanta, alpha particle using only bulk crystal scintillator. But if we look on the value for separation T alpha, T gamma, T alpha, T beta, and T alpha, T gamma, it is not so large, something between 1.3 up to 1.5. It's not so large value of such ratio. So probably in case when we use such type substrate or maybe another type substrate together with a film scintillator, the separation of decay profile in case of registration, such type radiation, probably will be better. So I would like to present some results related to scintillator properties of two-layered composite scintillators based on GIGG substrate with a different gallium content. Firstly, we can see that two-layered scintillators based on mixing cation films such as lutetium, gadolinium, aluminium garnet doped with cerium film and GIGG substrate with gallium concentration 2.5. La figura demonstrated the registration alpha particle using composite scintillator and using GIGG substrate. So the peak position indicates that alpha particle fully stopped in film scintillator because we have the different position of signal in case registration alpha particle by the composite scintillator and by the substrate. But in case of gamma quanta registration, the peak position is quite close. So main part of gamma quanta absorbed by the bulk crystal scintillator. We also receive a separation between decay profile in case of registration alpha particle and gamma quanta. So respective T alpha and T gamma ratio demonstrated that such separation of decay profile can be performed with respective value, such ratio between 1.3 and 2.1. It's enough for time discrimination of signal in case of alpha particle and gamma quanta registration, but probably such separation can be improved in other type of composite scintillator. A second example of two-layered composite scintillator, we consider the film containing gadolinium, aluminium, and gallium cations with concentration something between 1.65 and 2.15, and GIGG substrate with concentration gallium concentration 2.5. Under alpha particle registration, the peak position indicate that such type particles fully absorbed in film scintillator. The position very different in the position of peak position at registration alpha particle by the GIGG substrate. So, only alpha particles are absorbed by the film scintillator. In case the gamma quanta registration, the peak position quite different due to fact that probably partly gamma quanta absorbed by the film scintillators, and due to lower light yield of film scintillators, the peak position slightly shifted to the low channels. Anyway, main the disadvantages of started scintillators is, of course, low light yield of film part. But in case of decay kinetic, we observe very nice separation of decay profile in case of alpha particle registration and gamma quanta. It's an interesting question. Why we observe such large differences between decay kinetic in case when the content of film quite close to content of substrate? Of course, we always keep the smaller concentration of gallium ions here in such a way, slightly accelerate, of course, decay kinetic, but not so. But probably such acceleration decay kinetic is connected with the fact that such type of field also contain large concentration of lead ions in 2+ state coming from the flux agent, because such films are grown on from lead oxide based flux. In such way, part of cerium ions are recharged to cerium for plus state, and such recharging resulted in strong acceleration of decay kinetic of film in comparison with crystals where the cerium ions is in conventional three plus state. A result of such separation of decay profile under registration alpha and gamma quanta, the respective T alpha, T gamma ratio is large and is between 3.0 and 4 for such type scintillator. Anyway, we try to remove such disadvantages of this combination of composite scintillators, use another type of film, and we consider the creation of such type of two-layered composite scintillator using terbi aluminium garnet based film grown GG substrate with gallium content 2.5. The light yield of film scintillator is significantly better than in previous two cases, and quite comparable even the light yield of substrate. The peak, the close position of peak under gamma quanta registration also indicates the main part of gamma quanta absorbed by the bulk crystal part of composite scintillator. So in this way, we can confirm that such type of two-layered composite scintillator is the best at the moment in all composite scintillators based on mixed garnet film and crystals. For this reason, we also consider the possibility of time separation, decay profile in the kinds of alpha particle registration and gamma quanta registration. In case of combination TBRG films with GGG substrate, we observe really good separation of decay profile in the wide time interval, and the respective T alpha T gamma ratio is between 1.5 up to 3.2 for this type of composite scintillators. It's less than in second combination, but significantly better than in first type of composite scintillator. But I would like to concern your attention that the main advantages of such combination is a very high light yield of composite scintillator at quite good separation of decay profile in case of registration alpha particle in gamma quanta. For this reason, we also applied such two-layered composite scintillator for registration three type of ionization irradiation, including beta particles. As you can see, very nice separation of course alpha particle and gamma quanta, alpha particle and beta particle. Also, using such type scintillator, it is possible to separate it even beta quanta and gamma quanta. The respective T gamma T beta ratio it between 1.3 up to 1.8. But at 0.1 level, we observe the best separation of all decay profile. And in principle, even two-layered composite scintillator can be applied for separation of multilayer three type of ionization radiation. But anyway, we try to improve the situation with registration of three type of ionization radiation. And for this reason, we developed three-layered composite scintillators based on GGG substrate and consider as a scintillator property. First of all, I would like to show you the possible combination for creation three-layered composite scintillators based on garnet compound. First examples of such scintillator is stack film grown on gadolinium, lutetium, gallium, aluminium doped with cerium film on GIGD substrate with gallium content 2.5. Next example is a YAG doped film grown on TAG single crystalline film and on GIGD substrate with gallium content 2.5 and 2.7. Of course, at creation such type composite scintillator, we still keep the misfit of between films and substrate or between the different type of film below 1%, below 1%. The scintillation decay profile of first type three-layered composite scintillator, including TAG film, gadolinium, lutetium, aluminium, garnet doped with cerium film, and GGD substrate with gallium content 2.5, demonstrated good separation between at alpha particle registration and gamma quanta, of course. Of course, the same situation at the simultaneous registration beta particles and alpha particles. Not so good separation decay profiles in case registration of beta particles in gamma quad. Not enough for good separation. For this reason, we consider another type of composite scintillators based on YAG film, TAG film as second layers, and GG substrate with gallium content 2.5. For this type of composite scintillators, the scintillator decay profile and the alpha particle is received very fast. But separation of decay profile in case of beta particles registration in gamma quanta is not so large. It's not so. And such situation necessary to improve. For this reason, we perform some changes in the content of such combination. First of all, we change the gallium substrate on substrate with gallium content 2.7. In such way, we try to accelerate the decay profile on the gamma quanta registration. We also increase the thickness of TAG films here due to fact that beta particles mainly absorb in the second film. As a result, we possess very nice separation decay profile on the alpha, beta, and gamma simultaneous registration. So for this type scintillators, really, the all decay profiles can be simply separated using time discrimination and respective time value T alpha, T beta, T gamma, T gamma, T alpha, and T beta, T beta, T alpha are equal to 4.5 or even above 8 for such type scintillator. At the moment, this is the best type of three-layer composite scintillator for simultaneous registration of different kind ionization radiation, including alpha particles, beta particles, and gamma quad. We also consider now another type of combination based on TAG garnet and GRGG based films with quite lower gallium content than in case of substrate, the gallium content 3. We perform LPA growth offset of such type composite scintillators, and now we investigate the scintillators properties of such composite scintillators. Probably I can present the result on next international conference. It is very interesting to consider another approach for creation composite scintillators based on the same matrix, such as lutetium aluminium garnet, but use another type of dopant for time separation of decay profile in case of registration, different kind of ionization radiation. So we consider several type of combination for producing composite scintillators based on UR garnets, but I would like to show today only one example, best examples of creation such type composite scintillator. We consider, first of all, substrate doped with scandium ion, and using such type substrate, we produce two-layered composite scintillators based on LUAG doped with praseodymium film on LUAG with scandium substrate. Based on such type composite scintillators, we create two types of three-layered composite scintillators. LUAG doped with cerium film on LUAG doped praseodymium film as second layer, and LUAG doped with scandium substrate is some kind of home epitaxial layers without any misfit between the two films and substrate. But it's not necessary to use for alpha particle registration so heavy semi compound. So we can substitute it LUAG doped with cerium on YAG doped with cerium with significantly smaller density in comparison, and of course price in comparison with LUAG. So in such way we create combination YAG cerium film LUAG dopodis praseodymium film on luac dopodis scandium substrate is some kind of quasi homo epitaxial growth, but we still keep the same condition for producing or film with a misfit below even 1% for producing of such types scintillator. The Kaldur-Meissner spectra of a different part of composite scintillators, film doped with the cerium with the emission in the visible range, and film doped, a crystal doped with scandium praseodymium ion with the emission of UV range. So for producing composite scintillators, we need the for detector, respective detector with application of composite scintillators, we need the photomultiplier with quite wide spectral sensitivity from UV up to visible range. The Palhaes spectra of first type of composite scintillators based on Luac garnet, two-layered composite scintillators, also demonstrated the registration alpha particles using film part of composite scintillators, and gamma quanta, mainly due to absorbing of gamma quanta by the bulk crystal scintillator. The peak position in case of registration gamma quanta using the only Luac doped with scandium substrate is quite different than in case of composite scintillators. Probably such shift connected with a quite smaller light yield of films and absorbing part of gamma quanta by the film scintillators due to very high density and effective atomic number of Luac. But maybe it is not so important because in case of registration alpha particles in gamma quanta, we have received very nice separation decay profile. This is a decay profile in under gamma quanta registration, and black curve represents the decay profile in case of alpha particle registration. So the respective value, very T alpha, T gamma value, very high, and can be even from 2 up to even 7.6 at 0.05 level. So it's very nice separation decay profile. For this reason, we use this combination also for producing three-layered composite scintillators and put on the top of such two-layered composite scintillators also the film YAG doped with cerium. In such a way, such type composite scintillators applied for registration, so simultaneous registration alpha, beta, and gamma quanta. As you can see from this figure, we really receive very nice separation of three type of mentioning the three type of ionization radiation. So respective T alpha T gamma ratio for such type composite scintillator is equal above it to T gamma T beta ratio is something close to six, and T alpha T beta ratio even above 14. For such, it's very nice result. So at the moment, the best examples of composite three-layered composite scintillators based on simple Luac garnet. Please take into account very interesting moment because for acceleration scintillate decay kinetic of the second film scintillator, we use gallium alloying. In such a way, we receive very fast scintillator response of such type scintillator in comparison with film without gallium doping. I would like also talk shortly about the possibility of creation composite scintillator screen, because such ideology of development composite scintillator for radiation monitoring can be simply transmitted for producing scintillator screen. Now I would like to say that the simple crystalline scintillator scheme is mainly applied in for creation of microtomography detector using typical X-ray sources or synchrotron radiation facility. We working together with development of film scintillators with group Dr. Thierry Martin from synchrotron radiation facility in Grenoble, and such group produced the first examples of detector for visualization Such detector use the single crystalline film scintillators based on garnet compound, silicate compound, or perovskite compound, and images formed in the film scintillators and projected using microscopic optic to CCD camera as recording device. I must say that resolution of such images using synchrotron radiation is very, very, very nice. It's really below 1 micron, as you can observe on this figure. But I must say that next generation of scintillator screen need to realize two new approaches in development of such types. First concept connected with development of multilayered film scintillator screen, as you can see here, with separate pathway for registration of optical signal coming from each film layered scintillator. So we can receive even two images and mix it together in the end. In such a way, significantly improve the contrast resolution of images even submicron range. I must say that such novel concept demand creation of different kind of heavy and fission scintillators, because we need the separate need absorbed the gamma X-ray quanta using very scintillators with very small thickness and only few micron. And such type of film scintillators can be deposited with some non-luminescent or luminescent substrate, so it's some kind of three-layer composite scintillator. We also can use for this purpose not only the cerium ions or other fast-emitting ions, but also typical terbium or europium emission due to fact that usually scintillator respond for visualization are recorded in a wide time interval close to 1 to 10 milliseconds. Another approach for development of composite scintillator screen is so-called K-engineering, because for several applications, we need to receive the imagery from inside materials using quite high energy range of synchrotron radiation or X-ray, but we need for this purpose is also the film scintillator is quite larger absorption ability. Such a large absorption ability can be received in the produced single crystalline film scintillator with a mixed cation content. So we can mix cations such as yttrium, gadolinium, terbium, and lutetium. In such a way, we can mix the pH of different compound and significantly improve the absorption ability in film in such energy range. I would like to say that very interesting to create multilayer composite scintillators, including key engineering, based also on terbium aluminium garnet containing films, because such type of garnet possess extremely low afterglow. Such parameter is very important for development of scintillator screen. So this is a nice occasion to apply terbium aluminium garnet based scintillators for development of such multilayer scintillator screen. I would like to move to the conclusion of my presentation and say that recently developed single-crystalline film scintillators based on simple cerium doped YAG, LUAG, and TBAG garnet, as well as new efficient single-crystalline film scintillators based on cerium doped mixed garnet containing gadolinium, lutetium, aluminium, and gallium cations, can be successfully applied for creation composite film crystal scintillators using LPE growth method for simultaneous registration of the different component of the mixed ionization flux. From all studied, doubly layered composite scintillators, the best properties possess the gadolinium, aluminium, gallium based film, grown on GGD substrate with gallium content 2.5, and film, of course, the gallium concentration equals smaller. And another example is efficient two-layered scintillators is stack film grown on GGD substrate with gallium content 2.5. We also report on creation triplilariate composite scintillators based on cerium-doped single crystalline film of simple immixed garnet and GGG substrate with gallium content between 2.5 and 2.7. The best scintillator properties possess combination of YAG, TAG films grown on GGG substrate with gallium content 2.7. We report also on creation different type of doubly layered composite scintillators based on the film and crystal of Luac garnet, doped with a different kind of, including cerium ions, praseodymium ions, and scandium ions. The best scintillator properties possess lutetium aluminium garnet doped with the praseodymium ions, grown on Luac doped with scandium substrate. We report also on creation triplilariate composite scintillators based on cerium and praseodymium doped Luac in Luac films and Luac doped with scandium crystal substrate. The obtained result can be used for development of composite scintillator screen for imaging detection. Finally, in the end of my presentation, I would like to say that I hope that coronavirus situation next years will be significantly better. And I would like to invite you for next LUMDER 2020 conference in Bydgoszcz, in Poland. Conference will be organized in the first part of September. The organizer of conference will be Institute of Physics, Kazimierz Wielki University in Bydgoszcz, and Memorial Okrągły Center in Bydgoszcz. The conferences will be organized in a nice conference center of oncology center in Bydgoszcz. So we hope that we meet with you and other colleges in normal way. We probably can create quite rich social program. I hope that part of us remember the organization of last Eurodim conferences in Bydgoszcz. So I invite you to LUMDER 2021 conference in Bydgoszcz. And finally, I would like to thank for your attention and my also special thank to Professor Rob Jackson and Professor Mario Valerio for organization of so nice EGDIM 2020 conference.